All right. Returning to the radiation fallout methodologies for the food supply, right away, quickly, I'll mention the sunflowers are a leacher. They actually take the potassium and the elements of calcium mimicker and from the cesium and the strontium elements of the fallout. And they obtain them right from the soil. So you can grow the sunflowers to strain and filter the soil. Yet those sunflowers are also still containing these items, and because they're containing these items, also they're not extremely full and palatable to the body also. So it's not a really good idea to eat them, and those birds eating them will be most likely inheriting deficiencies and die from that overconsumption if they are specific to grab at it. Anything that's specific to looking for a calcium-potassium mimicker or calcium and potassium, that particular source is going to hit the birds pretty heavy also. You can try this. You can try to filter your own garden soil, and use it as a filter. However, as a particular it works happy. It's always better to have the greenhouse. It's always better to have the greenhouse, and grow the garden inside the greenhouse and. So you don't end up with a recurrent fallout from the thousand years recycle project of nuclear fallout. And so there, I don't know, that was a dream a long time ago. I was very pushy with, I have to have a greenhouse, even live in the greenhouse. And grow the lilies in there, and just have a lily business or something. Grow water lilies. That was a long time pushy wife want. Yeah, and then even just as a housing substitute combination on a large greenhouse with living inhabitants there, and also grow the food. I know, it's tough there, huh? Always looking for you know, the easy way to live, you know, and it seems like such an incredible hardship instead, doesn't it?